Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Benjamin and this is Sartorial Styles. And I'm very excited because today I have two parcels here from Undandy straight out of Portugal with DHL Express. Yesterday they gave it to DHL and today it's already in Germany. So the shipping was extremely fast. Before I start to talk about my experience with Undandy, I just want to point out what is the content of this video. First, I will talk about my experience with their customer service and just how I like the customer service. Second is the unboxing, and the third thing will be a first try of the shoes I'm going to unbox. So let's start with the ordering process and that stuff. There are many videos about how to customize your shoes with Undandy and it's pretty self-explaining. So if you're interested in trying it out, just go to their website and try their customizer. It's very easy. What isn't said in too many videos is that they say in their FAQs that your shoes will arrive after around 20 days. So they say that it takes 14 days for them to handcraft your shoes and a few more days to ship them to your location. That also depends on the location you are and on the shipping service you select. In this case, I waited around 2 months for my Undandy shoes. That's way more than 2 weeks. And they apologized several times. In the first, I asked them after around 2.5 weeks, okay, hey, are you already finished? And they said no, because there was a quality issue with the shoe and they kind of forgot to handcraft it again. So they had to wait until the holiday season in Portugal was over. And that's why there was another 2 week delay. And then they began to handcraft my shoes again and then they shipped them. So there was a huge delay. They apologized several times. They offered me a 20% discount for my next order. They sent me a very nice handwritten letter and they also gave me a leathered shoe horn for free. Very nice. So in general, I didn't feel like I was exploited or something, but they really cared about me as a customer. That's extremely important in my opinion. And I never felt like they treated me bad or something. The correspondence was always very nice and friendly. The people have always been extremely polite. They responded very quick. So in general, there was a delay. There should not be a delay. If they say it takes 14 days to handcraft them, then it should take 14 days or better less. But sometimes things like that happen and I was very pleased by how well the customer service handled the delay and the problems that occurred. Let's start with unboxing those items. I think the shoes here will be the last thing I will unbox. I just start with this little box right here. I didn't order only the shoes, but also a shoe care kit, I think, or something similar. I don't really remember it, but I think I ordered a shoe care kit. And that should be this one. It's a very nice box here. Nothing fancy, but there's an Undandy logo on it. I think this will also, okay, this actually looks quite nice. Nice black box here. Conspicuously inconspicuous. Then with Undandy logos on both sides and nothing on the back. I'll just open it and see what is inside. Okay. Yeah, it says this is a shoe care kit and also some descriptions what is actually inside. And on the back side, you can see some instructions on how to use those items. Very nice, always cool to have something like that. It's printed on a very nice thick paper. I definitely like it. Then what is also noticeable on pretty much every item here, you can see an Undandy logo. Again, this is a horsehair brush. Probably it's a horsehair brush, yeah. Very cool, definitely suitable for lighter colored shoes because of the lighter colored hair. So nothing I would use for a black shoe, but I didn't order a black shoe though, so that's completely fine. Then this little Dauber brush. I don't really know. I actually don't know for what this is, probably for the edges of the shoe, or I will find it out, but it's a nice brush. What I have to say is that the wood here feels very nice and solid, definitely better than on the shoe care kit I already own, which was extremely cheap, to be honest, but this one feels like a quality item, no question. So then we have this polishing cloth, and then we have this one. Yeah, this is a transport bag. If you want to travel with the shoe care kit, then you can take it with you in this nice yellow bag. In general, I think the yellow inside of the box looks pretty cool. And then we have two things here. Number one is a neutral shoe polish. I hope it's the right, yeah. A neutral shoe polish. I decided to go with a neutral shoe polish because I went for patina shoes and I didn't want to destroy the patina with a colored shoe polish or shoe wax or whatever. That's why I went for neutral ones and also neutral shoe wax. So we have both things here in this shoe care kit. Definitely a nice kit, not the biggest one. I've seen way bigger kits, but it's the most important stuff you definitely need if you want to take care of your shoes, and it's extremely nice to have something like that. The shoe care kit was kind of for free for me because there was a discount at their website and I used this discount, and that's why I paid exactly the same price with the shoe care kit than I would pay normally without the shoe care kit for the shoes. So this was kind of a free gift for me, and I think regularly it's around 40 bucks, which is definitely a good price for good shoe polish, good shoe wax, and some accessories to use this. Nice, I like it. And now box number two, hopefully the shoes. Okay, that's done. So this is the shoe box, same design, exactly the same design actually. Also with the Undandy logos right here. Good, let's open it. Okay. I see, oh, okay, first I smell something, definitely. That smells like leather. again, we have a transport, not case, a transport bag. Again, yellow, very cool. Nice design, definitely. So let's see what we have here. This is nothing. So, oh yes. Huh. That looks very cool, to be honest. Such a nice and sleek shoe. I like the very thin sole of this one, very suitable for the warmer climate. I also like the patina a lot. The color is very nice and also what I expected due to the renderings they had. What I notice is that the patina isn't put on very regular. So we have a little bit of excess patina here. That is a little bit like when you paint a wall, for example, and you just had a little bit too much paint on your brush, and then you have those excess paint. I'm not sure if you can see it like that. Maybe you can, I don't know, but that's not a huge problem in my opinion. I like the cut very much. It has a little bit of a kind of squared toe actually, but I wanted to try it. I have round toes mostly, but this one is more of an Italian design and it has a little bit of a squared toe, but I like it. In general, the silhouette of the shoe looks extremely nice in my opinion. Very cool. I like the color a lot. I like the feel of the leather. It's very soft, but not too, soft. It's still very stiff leather, with a little bit stiffer here in the back, of course. Yeah, the sole is also made out of leather, like you can see here. It's probably a Blake stitch. A nice sole indeed. Also here on the sole you can see that there is a little bit of the patina color. But yeah, a nice shoe. Let's check out the second one. I really love the color. The color is extremely, extremely cool. Definitely awesome for every kind of summer look with linen, for casual but also formal. Also the buckles seem to be very, very nice. There is also a little bit of color on the buckles, but as I said, that can happen when painting a shoe like that. I'm very excited how these will fit and how they will feel on the feet. You will see that right now, my first fitting, and I will tell you some of my first impressions. Ladies and gentlemen, just very quick and dirty film with the smartphone's camera. How do I like the Undandy shoes after around 2 or 3 days of wearing? I know it's not really a first impression right now, but I didn't have the time to shoot this when I first wore them. Because of that, I will just tell you my first or second or third impressions now. So the shoes are a little bit larger and especially longer than I expected. So this is more a 42 and a half or even a 43 than an actual 42, but it's still okay. They could fit better. They are a bit loose, but I think a 41 would be too tight. So probably that's the way to go for me when it comes to their sizes. The leather quality is very nice. The shoes aren't hurting anywhere or something. The leather is not too stiff. It's very soft. It's very, very comfortable to walk with these shoes, especially because of the very thin sole and the Blake construction. So when it comes to comfort, I'm very satisfied. Besides that, they are, as I said, a little bit too big. But on the other hand, I noticed that there are those wrinkles on the shoe coming very fast. So extremely fast, actually. Already after around 2 or 3 hours of wearing, I had massive wrinkles in the leather of the shoe. And that didn't happen to shoes from Shoe Passion, for example. So I will definitely have to see how these shoes will look in 2 months or 1 year. But from now, I can tell you that I think that they will break faster than Goodyear welted shoes from Shoe Passion, for example. I will do an in-depth review about Undandy in a few months when I was wearing these shoes more often. But for now, this is my first impression of the Burgundy Undandy double long straps I just unboxed. That was the first fitting of the Undandy double long straps in Burgundy. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and feel free to subscribe to this channel. I will upload menswear and fragrance content frequently. Thank you very much for listening and have a nice day.